Hi, I'm David with General Air. In our last couple of videos, we've been talking about E71T-11 inner shield flux cored wire. This video, we're gonna do a few more welding positions and talk about some limitations and some abilities of this really cool wire. I've got two setups here. I've got a 16 gauge coupon setup in an outside corner joint, and then I've got two 16 gauge coupons set in a butt joint. And I went vertical down, so I started here and went all the way down. Typically, you never want to do that with flux cored wire, especially on anything structural, because of that flux might trap itself inside the weld. But these are only thin material, not so worried about it. Let's break them in half and see what happens. All right, here's the outside corner joint, and I stepped on it with my boot and I got it almost flattened out before it broke. This leads me to a really important point about this wire. It does not have very good impact properties. Do not use E71T11 wire for anything structural. So if it fails and someone could get hurt, this is not the right wire to use. But you know what? Our plate didn't perform too bad. All right, here was the butt joint, and you can see we got this thing bent almost all the way around itself before it broke. So it actually had some strength to it. But just again, to remind you, this is not for structural applications. We were just trying to see if we could stick these two pieces together and have a weld that would hold some mild forces. So as I'd stated, we don't want to go vertical down with our wire. We want to go vertical up, especially when we're on thick pieces like this. We want to point the wire uphill, and when we strike the arc, there's going to be a little slag shelf that's going to follow our puddle all the way up. You don't want to go so fast as to outpace that slag shelf because it's holding the puddle, or go so slow that you disrupt that little shelf and then the puddle falls out. All right, that bead turned out pretty good. We kept our wire upward angle and we just moved from point A to point B without any oscillation or anything like that. We just let that slag shelf build and hold our bead in place. Now, what would happen if we wanted a little bit bigger bead? Well, I'll show you. All right, in that same vertical up position where we kept our wire pointed up and we followed the slag shelf, we put a weld here that was halfway on the root pass and halfway on the plate. Then we shored up the other side with another bead halfway on the plate and the other half of the root bead. They met nicely in the middle there.